Hi everyone, coming out Coach Rick. I actually got out of my gym clothes now and have been busy working, and I decided I need a break. So I'm going to shoot a video. It's pretty easy. I just flip on my little Mac and use iMovie and off I go. So yesterday I posted a photo of Wonder Woman and started a dialogue with a bunch of my female friends on Facebook, and this thing turned into a great bit of information that I'm going to use for probably the next few videos, and to kind of really dig into something that, well, okay, straight guys, you're not going to get included in this, but if you want to listen to it, you might learn something. So here's what this is going to be all about: why straight women and gay men have so much in common. And as I started the conversation around masculinity and what it means to be a powerful woman and why you can't let your power come forward, I got some great responses from some really, truly powerful women. And the first response that I got, which was pretty much the overriding theme, was when a woman shows her power, she comes off as masculine. Now, quite honestly, I'm a gay man, but I find powerful women really sexy. Now, sexy being, I find powerful women really being who they are and living their truth, which is what I'm all about. I'm a gay man. I live my truth. I am gay, and that's who I am. So I find strong, powerful women to be really sexy and hot. So doesn't mean I want to go do the nasty with them. It's just what I find kind of cool. The second thing that came forward is this fear of if I'm a strong woman that people might look at me as overbearing or overpowering or whatever. Well, isn't that kind of interesting that when us gay men start to show our power, whether we're strong butch guys or big daddy guys like me or effeminate, people kind of get wigged out at times. So we step back into our own place of fear. The third overriding theme that I can remember right off the top of my head that I found really interesting is women feel like they weren't socialized to equally show their femininity and be powerful in their masculine. Well, that's very similar to us gay guys. Hello, we weren't socialized to show our feminine side. We had to be the baseball players, football players, the masculine guys working in shop, all that stuff. When in reality, and I'm going to do a stereotype here, so please forgive me. When in reality, I would much rather have not been in the wood shop, working on a car, doing any of that stuff. I would have much rather been playing some music, doing some dancing, painting, and I know that sounds stereotypical, but that's who I was. Now I'm a pretty big strapping guy. I love working outside. I love doing yard work. I love working on the house. So it was probably just something that I had to grow into. But anyway, I'd love for you to stay tuned the next few days. I'm going to kind of go back through the responses that my beautiful ladies from Facebook gave me. And I'm going to keep drawing those parallels to why straight women and gay men have so much in common. And it isn't because we both like men. Okay, so get your minds out of the gutter. Stay tuned, and I look forward to sharing with you some observations over the next few days. So once again, coming out, Coach Rick here saying, go have a great day, and don't forget, step out, step up, and step in to living your truth every day of your life. Doesn't matter if you're a woman, a man, a straight man, a gay man, a lesbian woman, a transsexual, a transgender, you get the drift. Go live your truth. Have a great day, everyone. Bye-bye.